in the agricultural sector, the different modules or the different aspects of the project are supposed to assist farmers in several ways. The expense app, for example, would be a portable and quite accessible means of record keeping for farmers. Record keeping is one of the areas where farmers are very deficient in the Caribbean, and small farmers throughout the world for that matter. And therefore, having a device like that whereby farmers can keep their records on an ongoing basis and also get analysis of their records to get back useful information on their costs and revenue and profit position. That should be a very important tool for farmers to use to improve their profitability.
Okay, AgriNet was started by Dr. Bernard, and she asked me to get involved. And at that time, I was interested in the whole concept of open data, which is data that is freely available to the public and they can use it and republish it, etc. So I suggested that since AgriNet needed data from various organizations, we could use this open data model for the AgriNet project. However, open data is, we would like to have access of multiple forms of data, not only agriculture data.
Everyone, my name is Naris Sigelman. I'm the Network Systems Administrator for the Department of Computing and Information Technology, but I'm also the IT person that is dealing with the AgriNet project. So all the AgriNet infrastructure in terms of IT, I'm the main coordinator and the administrator. So yourself, where is the AgriNet server? I would say, essentially, the AgriNet project is right there. All our AgriNet projects are running on this. They're actually multiple servers, multiple websites that are actually running on this server. We have our data TT, our max.tt, r.tt, and MCC, I think. It's the TT. It's also running on these each, and they're separate virtual machines, each managing their own separate data sets.